Hi everyone, in this video we are talking about PV mathematical models. So why we need PV mathematical models is we use this model to do the simulation. Simulation is an important tool to reproduce the behavior of PV power system. The PV mathematical model is to find an equation to describe the IV curves. As PV cell is constructed from silicon p-n junction, a diode model is used to represent the PV cell. A very simple model now we're introducing called ISDM model, which means ideal single diode model. There are many other complex ways to build the model. This is also a research area in PV system. We will use this simplest model to learn how to build the PV model first. And if you have interest, you can build more complex model later. So first of all, let's have a look of the ISDM model equation. Here is the equation of IPV and VPV. The IPH is the current source current, and all this part is the diode current. And this equation is the relationship between IPV and VPV. The known parameters in this equation are listed in here. We can put all this together as VTCS, and the value is 25.7 millivolts. In this equation, the three unknown values are IS, AN, and IPH. And now we are going to identify them. First of all, we put the two terminals together to short the circuit diode. Then we can have the IPH is equal to IPV. And the IPV now we can find in datasheet is our ISC, which is our short circuit current. Then we put our model into open circuit. So now our IPH equals to ID, and our IPH already calculated as the last step is ISC. So the equation became to ISC equals to IS times e to the power of VOC, which is our open circuit voltage divided on VTCS times AN minus 1. And this equation cannot solve anything, so that we need to put a load at the terminal of our model to make our model work in MPP point. At this time, our PV cell output IPV equals to IMPP and our VPV equals to VMPP. So our IMPP equals to IPH minus ID, and by replacing IMPP ISC value into this equation, we can get IMPP equals to ISC minus IS times e to the power of VMPP divided on VTCS times AN minus 1. By combining equation 1 and 2, we can get this equation. It's e to the power of VMPP divided on VTCS times 1 on AN minus 1 divided on e to the power of VOC divided on VTCS times 1 on AN minus 1 equals to 1 minus IMPP divided on ISC. So this is a nonlinear equation, and by making the 1 on AN to Ainf, we can put this equation as the function related to Ainf. So the function is FAinf equals to e to the power of C in Ainf minus C3 e to the power of C2 Ainf minus 1 plus C3 equals to 0. The C1, C2, C3 value is listed here. You can use the solve function in MATLAB to solve this equation. And by solving this equation, we know the value of Ainf. And by putting the Ainf into 1 on Ainf, we can get our An. And by put all the already known value into IS equals to ISC divided on e to the power of c2 times a inf minus 1, we can get the IS value. So till now we know that our IPH equals to I short circuit current, and by solving the function of a inf, we can get the value of an. And by replacing the AN value in the IS equation, we know the IS value. Now we know the equation on standard test condition, we can add on the variation with irradiance and temperature. The temperature and irradiance coefficients can be found in your datasheet, and I've pointed out in the last video. Basic concept is you just times if coefficient onto the equation. So the main equation is IPV equals to IPH related to EA and delta T minus IS related to EA and delta T still times to e to the power of QVPV divided on KDCAN minus 1. And our IPH equation is EA divided on ESTC times ISC times 1 plus alpha T times delta T. And our IS equation is IPH IPH equation divided on e to the power of QVOC related to EA and delta T divided on KDCAM minus 1. And our VOC equation is VOC times 1 plus the delta T times delta T times gamma T. The last part is we actually build this in the MATLAB Simulink. So this is the ISDM model I built in MATLAB. So this is all the known parameter in our equation. And here I'm building a PV panel that weighs 36 cells. And this is my values from the data sheet, and this is the temperature coefficients, and this is the irradiance coefficients, and this is C1 to C3, and this is the equation of ISDM model, and this is how I solved the AN. And this are how I calculate VPV and PPV. And this part is to build the temperature and irradiance difference. And all these are plotting things. So in MATLAB Simulink, there's two ways to use the PV model. The first way is to directly use the PV array the MATLAB Simulink supply. So by double click it, you can choose the parallel cell number. You put your number in here and serial cell number, and by choose user define, you can change the open circuit voltage, short circuit current, VMPP and IMPP in here according to the value in your datasheet, and also the temperature coefficients according to your datasheet. And by applying, here is the irradiance value and here is the temperature value, you can get the PV output from these two nodes. And you also can directly connect this to your DC-DC converter and DC-AC converter. Another way is to use MATLAB function. To use this function, And by editing this function using all the parameters you are calculated here, you are actually using the ISDM model to put the current value back into your circuit. What you need to do is you need to use this controlled current source. So you put your calculation value back to this controlled current source and connect this current source to your circuit. Then you can have a self-built PV model. So yes, this is two way that you can build up your PV model. This is all for this video. Thank you for watching this video. We will see you in next video.